Trader Joe's since fall started, and I didn't even realize because I've just been going to like Grocery Outlet and where else have I been going? Sprouts mainly. But I totally forgot about all their like fall, like seasonal things that they come out with. Sometimes they come out with new stuff. So I'm like super excited that I went today because I found a lot of cool like little vegan finds and seasonal things. The one that I'm most, where'd you put it? The one that I'm most excited about. Bag this so perfect because I don't want to, I'm already messing it up. Crap it. So the one that I'm most excited about is this one. The Hold the Dairy cones. Because I always seen the Hold the cone whatever ones, but they never had a vegan kind. And this is perfect for like portion control. I was so juiced when I saw this, like honestly so juiced. As well as the kimchi tofu thing. They also have some vegan pizza, which I was surprised they didn't have for so long. A bunch of pumpkin stuff, pumpkin everything. And I finally got myself the little mini pumpkins because I always put the little small ones in my room. Normally we get like big pumpkins or whatever from the pumpkin patch, or if we're super last minute we get them from the store, but yeah, we'll have like a big one that we'll let the kids decorate or just leave outside or whatever for decoration. But yeah, so now I spent more than expected in Trader Joe's. Normally I only spend about $40 at most when I just go and get like my regular essentials. But because I found all these cool new finds, I spent like $50. Which is not bad, but, water break. I'm about to slide through Target really quick to get, literally just coffee, because the Starbucks one that I have the grounds of, it's good. I have the espresso roast, but I find that it's a little too acidic. Like after I drink it, I'm always getting acid reflux. It happens with, you know, coffee in general, but I don't like that it's that bad when I drink that one. So, and that's not the cold brew, that's like the actual like grounds that I make. And then so I'm like, let me go get restock on Chameleon, and I would just go to like Safeway or anywhere to get it, but a lot of times they just don't have the Chameleon concentrate, or they only have one version of it. That's what I'm gonna go get. It's definitely getting a lot colder these days. But I think I'm just a person that likes cold coffee and cold tea over like hot any days. I'm probably gonna continue getting cold brew for a minute until I get tired of it and I want to make my own coffee. Let me leave because she looks like she's trying to get in. All right, so into Target we go. I wonder if I'm gonna see Dee Dee. She works at this one. I was just saying, I wonder if I'm gonna see Dee Dee, and there she goes.
Period.
Period. Where they got you at today?
Dry Gloves. I'm back there.
Oh, so you're delivering, so you get to go outside.
Yeah. That's the only good part about the shop. I hate waiting.
Is he on register?
I don't know where he's at, yeah. He might be collecting carts.
Probably run into him.
Let me text him.
I was literally just saying, I was like, I wonder if I'll see Dee Dee or Taco
today.
Wait,
I'm gonna get you now. Hold on. Look who wanted to be there. Oh, dang it. No, there isn't.
She just got called.
Is there any audio in the back? Just the instant mix? I can check right now. I'm helping a guest.
I'm the guest.
I didn't even know you was coming.
I didn't know I was coming either. I was going to Trader Joe's. I just came back, but I needed coffee. So I was coming.
Yeah, and I don't know where nothing's out here, so don't ask me.
What kind of worker are you?
I'll be in the back. I just do what I gotta do to get by.
You like a funny.
But yeah, you might see him around here.
Yeah, I'm gonna walk around. I don't know what I need to get. I'm just gonna browse. Have fun. Yay, I did good. So this is literally the best. Ooh, look at my hand. This is literally my go-to coffee. Like, I feel like it's just the best. If you want like a more, like less expensive, more affordable cold brew, not concentrate, but just cold brew in general, I would tell people go for the Stoke. That used to be my go-to as well before I started doing the cold brew concentrates. But I just feel like this is more espresso-y to get like the concentrated version one, rather than getting like just the regular cold brew. And this guy is looking at me as I'm doing my little haul. I also found these little, what's it call it? These little stickers. But so yeah, mission executed. I don't need to spend another dime today, even though I did pretty good. But I just didn't like plan on having like such a big grocery thing. But I got exactly everything that I needed, so that is great. Alright guys, so I wanted to show you guys our full workout this day on the track. A lot of times you'll see like bits and pieces of it throughout my vlogs, but I wanted to show you guys a full one of what we did this time. So we're starting off with some sprints, followed up by a jog, a lap around the track. So we'll sprint down 100 meters and then jog the rest. And then once we get back, we'll rest for a second and then take off again. So we do that for a total of 4 times. And our rests are about 30 seconds to a minute long. What I did not show was our warm-up and our stretching. So obviously we do warm up and stretch before we start tackling these type of exercises or any type of exercise for that matter. Okay, so that basically was a mile in total, but we did 100 meter sprints, jogged the rest of the lap for a total of 4 times, and I feel good, surprisingly, but it's a nice way to quick start the session. After we finished our run, we take a quick little water break, catch our breath, and then we go on to this next exercise. So this day we focused on a lot of defensive drills. So our first round, we are doing some defensive slides. And then once they hear the bell or the whistle, they have to drop and we'll do some push-ups until you hear the bell again. And then you'll get back into it and do slides again. And then once you hear the bell, etc., etc. In this one, you really want to try to move as quickly as you can. It does like test your endurance and your stamina, but you're trying to move as quickly as you can. And when you drop to push-ups and get back up, you want to get back up as quickly as you can as well. Back in mine, we can get a little closer now. Smoke up, just talk shit out. Wanna know a little more about your girl, about your girl. So we do that a couple of times with the push-ups. Then the next one, instead of push-ups, when you hear the bell, you have to do burpees. So this one's a little bit tougher, but another variation of what we do. And there's no exact like time or number of reps. I just kind of go until I feel that they are tired enough and then I stop, give us a little break, and then I'll go again. This next one is a burpee variation. So they're doing a lateral jump straight into a one leg burpee. I know it sounds kind of weird and sounds a little bit difficult. It is kind of weird at first to try it out, but once you get it down, you kind of get the motion of it. You're doing it the same exact thing of a burpee, except for when you go down, you're going down on one foot and then you're jumping up with one leg as well. Yeah.
And this one we do in intervals of 35 to 45 seconds, depending on how we're feeling. So we'll do it for 35 seconds on, and then they'll get 30 second rest, and then we'll do it again. Next, we move on to our circuit. So this one, we have some footwork focused drills within the circuit, and they kind of just go around in a circle and do each of the movements. So they run up, you can't really see the full thing from this angle, but we're doing a run up to the cone, and then we jog back, and then we run up to the next cone, jog back. And then once we get to the last cone, you have the ladders, and we do a little footwork with the ladders over to the bench where you do your jumps pretty much over the bench. And then from there, you're going to do bear crawls all the way back to get to the start point of the cone. We do about 3 to 4 rounds of this circuit through, and then we take another water break, and then we'll go into our last burnout exercise. So our last exercise is what I always like to call our burnout. It's basically just burning out whatever is left in the tank, giving it your all before you end for the session of the day. So for this burnout session, we're doing abs. So we do like a little 10-minute ab circuit with minimal rest in between. So we'll go for like 45 seconds to a minute of one type of movement, and then we'll have a 10 to 15 second rest in between and go straight into the next movement for about 10 minutes in total, so about 10 different moves or so.
To stay with me tonight.
And that is all for our track workout for conditioning day. So let me know if you guys want to see more of these and I could record more of these instead of the smaller clips within the vlogs. Be sure to give this video a thumbs up if you like these workouts and want to see more of them more often. And until next time, make sure you subscribe so you can stay up to date on the latest vlogs.